They go out into foreign countries because that's what God's called them to do, to be missionaries. But you know, we've all been called to be missionary in our own community, to tell Jesus, to tell those about, to tell those that don't know about him, to tell them about Jesus. And you know, maybe you're sitting here tonight and maybe you've given your heart to the Lord a long time ago, but maybe tonight you've not got things right with him. You know, if you can lay down and you can say, if I were to die tonight, you know, would I be going to heaven or would I be going to hell? If you don't know for sure, then you've not made things right with the Lord. And you know, you need to do that. This would be the best time, the best Christmas to make things right with the Lord. And so I'm just going to go ahead and turn it over to the choir. But I hope you enjoy this. If you want to laugh, go ahead and laugh. Do whatever you feel like doing. We're going to have a good time.
I shop food, got ice cream at the food court, and watch the puppies. Ginny, we heard she was in an accident brought to this hospital. Now, where is she?
Can we see her?
Please.
Don't ask the wife off everybody else.
Wait, but oh, she's our friend. We've got to see her.
Take a number. Take a number and sit down. Number six, calling number six. Please approach the nurse's station at this time.
She's calling number six. What's her number?
319.
Oh, man, we'll be here today for Christmas.
Last call for number six.
Oh, I'm coming. Right here.
Number six, what seems to be the trouble?
Well, you see, I was ringing this bell for charity at the mall, and I was using the standard up and down technique,
and my elbow got stuck.
I see. Arm in upright and locked position, initial diagnosis, elbow receiver. We see a lot of that this time of year. Fill out these forms and treatment, and don't forget insurance policy numbers.
But, ma'am, I'm right-handed, and it's my right hand that's stuck.
Hospital policy says you must fill out these forms before treatment.
If it was put the end of my hand.
Of course.
Thanks.
Wow, that's a freaky accident.
Yeah, I saw that guy standing there when we came in. I was thought he was waiting for somebody.
Number seven.
Number seven? John, this is going to take forever.
We've got to find a way to get to Ginny.
It's all my fault. Ginny was my best friend.
What?
Nikki? Pete, what are y'all doing here?
What do you mean Ginny was your best friend?
You mean she's expired?
No, no, we don't know anything for sure. All we know is that Ginny was in an accident after she left the mall.
I heard she was in a coma.
Yeah, I heard she was critical.
Heard she had amnesia.
Oh, cool. My mom thinks that every Christmas with those little oranges and coconut.
Pete, that's an ambrosia. Amnesia is the loss of memory.
Oh, yeah. I knew that. I just.
Number eight, please approach at this time.
You have to take a number?
Yeah.
Oh, but great news, there's only 311 people in front of us. What?
Hey, do you know that guy over there?
No, what?
Well, he was waving at me.
Maybe you should wave back to me.
Okay.
I say we may see Ginny right now.
Yeah, I don't want to wait until he's going on.
Ginny needs us. She may be lying in a sterile room. Cold and lonely, just gasping for air, calling out our names. Carly, that's terrible for you to have.
Especially when I think of Christmas.
Yeah, this is kind of where it should be perfect.
Just one time a year, Jesus, He's the joy of his name.
Quincy over here for a long time. Now, I know you have rules and regulations, and they're good rules too, but we've been waiting to see Jeannie, and we love her, and she needs us right now. So, it's Christmas, so don't you think?
Number 10.
Nothing to do. We can wish for a wish, we won't budge.
Nice try.
This is going to take forever.
I don't care how long it takes, I just want to see Jeannie.
Hey, do you see that guy, number 10, who just got called the nurse's desk?
You mean that guy with the tons like that?
Yeah, I must say, that's not a very nice gesture. Especially right here for Christmas.
Totally, Shanae. Just how did this happen? Tried to lick the ice off the flagpole. Too bad.
Give me if you need it.
Oh, Pete, I'm kidding. You need it. I love you guys.
felt it other times too. Times when I wasn't hurt so much on the outside, I hurt it on the inside.
Everybody, wake up. We're with triple digits already.
Good. Maybe it won't be too long.
Sometimes I risk it all. Sometimes I'm reckless.
Happy Christmas. I had this great, beautiful attitude going, you know? But there was this nurse who was really good in the holiday spirit. She was singing Away to Major and Up Here for a Bed while she took my temperature. For some reason, that song, it might be fun for this nativity scene to sing every year at Carly's house. I remember asking Carly once, my lady was born in the barn, and she said something about God's awesome plan. Then I asked her what made that baby so special that a whole holiday would revolve around him. She said something about hope and heaven, but really, I never understood it with all that.
Thank you.
I'll tell her now.
Tell me what?
Jenny!
Oh, I'm sorry! How are you feeling?
I'm fine.
What happened?
Well, a clumsy thing. I just sent into my small parking lot. So I came here. It was all swollen and hurting. It's not hard or anything. Just a bad spark.
Well, we're glad you're all right.
I can't believe y'all waited all night.
Jenny, we care about you. And we've got some things to tell you.
Yeah. Let's go down to the cafeteria and get some breakfast and talk.
Okay, great.
Jenny, you wouldn't have to have a few books for tomorrow, would you?
Yeah, we're sort of out of money.
It's a long story.
Yeah, how about breakfast? What's on your mind? Then, and this is the best part, real meaning of Christmas. See, my friends told me that God loved me enough to send me the gift of the Son. And they told me about Jesus' sacrifice and how it gives us hope for now and heaven for later. Then they told me what Jesus meant to them. And that's what made the difference. They don't want to obey that. Well, one slippery spot in the road, one life turned upside down. All in all, I'd say it was a great night. The night I spent Christmas in the ER.
This is a comedy, but it's also serious, and so we during practice, we were practicing our lines, practicing these songs. You know, we all like to cut up a little bit. I'm probably the worst offender, and I'm sure I've got some people in trouble because of that. Being a Johnny, yeah, he's the second one there. But Whitney helps keep us in line, and she helps keep us motivated. It helps keep everything going the way it should. But I just want to give you this small token of appreciation on the cast of your crew. I just want to know that we do love you and we appreciate you.
Amen. Let's give them one more hand. Amen. Amen. Good job. It is the season. We're so happy you've chosen to come be with us tonight. These guys have worked so hard and done a good job. We went through the night with almost no technical difficulty whatsoever. Praise God. If you weren't here last night, you know what I'm talking about. But we enjoy doing these things. And every year, this is something that we look forward to, I guess you could say. And Scott mentioned that they started working in October, and throughout all the practices, it's a good time for us just to be together and laugh and have a good time. And my favorite moment just happened to be last night, in the midst of all of the technical stuff that happened, and during the scene where Mother Mary and Joseph came up here to the front, the little kids. Now, most people might have missed this one, but I was sitting right there in the middle. Trinity and Tristan were here, and Tristan missed his mark. He was standing not in the right place, and Mother Mary gave him the look. Anyway, it was so cool because she snapped her fingers a couple of times, and he you know, he was listening to the music and didn't hear him finally. She said, gave him, and for the first time in my life, I can relate to